फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर गौरव वर्मा। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन एल्गोरिथम एंड इट्स एग्जांपल्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द डिवीजन एल्गोरिथम? इट्स स्टेटमेंट इफ ए एंड बी आर एनी टू इंटीजर्स विद ए ग्रेटर देन जीरो, देन देयर एग्जिस्ट अ यूनिक इंटीजर क्यू एंड आर, सो दैट वी कैन राइट बी इज इक्वल टू ए क्यू प्लस आर, where r is a remainder, always less than divisor and greater than equal to 0. It is simply related with the division algorithm, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is a statement of division algorithm. Further, we have its corollary. Corollary, this result can be modified like this. If we take remainder minus a by 2 greater than equal to less than by a by 2, this result also can be used to solve various examples. In this video, we have taken the statement, we have read the statement of division algorithm. Now we will solve different examples using these two statements. Okay, so we will start with the first example. Prove that the fourth power of any integer is either of 5k or 5k plus 1. Here we have to take fourth power of any integer. Let us take b as any integer. We have to divide b with the a. So we have a division algorithm, b is equal to aq plus r. Since we have to answer 5k plus 1, in answer there exists 5 and 5k plus 1. So take a is equal to 5 here. So this is a statement. Now remainder will be less than 5, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. By putting the different values of r here, we get value of b here. B is equal to 5q, 5q plus 1, 5k plus 2, 5k plus 3, 5k plus 4, so on. In this way, we get different values of B. So every integer is of the form this type. Now we have to take fourth power of these integers. We have to take the fourth power of these integers. So first case, B is equal to 5q, sorry. Now taking fourth power on both sides, 5 raised to power 4 is 625. Taking 5 common, so we can write this as a k, where k is an integer. So this b is written in the form 5k, this one. Now take another case, 5q plus 1, make its power 4. Now you have to use binomial theorem here. How to use binomial theorem? 4c 0, a raised to power n, 4c 1, a raised to power q, 4c 2, a ki power square, so on. By using the binomial theorem, you can open this bracket, and from each expression you clearly see that there is a 5. So we can take 5 common from the each expression, each term. So it is written as, and this last term is 1, because NCN is always 1, because upper and smaller upper and lower index are same, so it will be a 1. And from these terms we can take 5 common. Okay, from there we can take 5 common, and this is only 1, so it is written as 5k plus 1. Similarly, we have another case, 5q plus 2, take power 4 on both sides, and applying binomial theorem. So applying binomial theorem, these are the terms, only last term will contain no power of q, and from first these terms we will take 5 common, and last term is number 1. So it is again written as a 5k plus 1. Similarly, we can take third case, fourth case, and we can prove that a number will be always of type this 5k or 5k plus 1. Take another case. So in this case, we have to solve. First of all, students, you have to solve the whole expression and take 5 common and keep 1 outside the bracket after taking the 5. And then in the last case, you can also hear open the bracket using a binomial theorem. If you solve this expression, after solving this expression, you have to keep here one number plus one outside the bracket, so that each power of fourth can be written as 5k or 5k plus one here. Now we have another problem. Every integer is of the form. So first part, we have to show that this integer is of the form this. So take b as an integer, take a is equal to 3 in the first part. So because as in answer there is a 3 exists, so we are taking a is equal to 3, And here we are using the corollary of division algorithm, that is we will use remainder like this. So if a is 3, then remainder will lie between minus 3 by 2, 3 by 2. It means value of remainder will be minus 1, 0, 1. Okay, when we put value of r here minus 1, 0, 1, we get these three integers which is of type this one. Okay. Now we have to do second part. In second part, students, we have 4k minus 2, 4k minus 1. So here we will take k is equal to 4. Okay, take q is equal to k. Then remainder will lie between minus a by 2, a by 2. It is minus 2, it is 2. So it is less than 2, it is greater than or equal to 2. So we will take minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1. By putting these different values here, we get different values of b here. Similarly, you can do third part by taking a is equal to 5. Similarly, you can do fourth part by taking a is equal to 6. Okay. Now another example: if m is an integer not divisible by 2 or 3, show that 24 will divide this. Where here we have to show that m is an integer which is not divisible by 2 or 3. Let us divide m by 6. If m divide by 6, by division algorithm, we can write m is equal to 6q plus r, because our a is 6 here and remainder will be less than 6, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we can't take remainder 0, 2, 3, 4 because it is given to us, it is not divisible by 2 or 3. So, option of 2, 3, and 4 is also cancelled out, and 0 is also cancelled out. So, we have only r is equal to 1, 5. So we have two cases, either m is equal to 6q plus 1, either 6q plus 5. So we will take first case, and our expression, this is our expression. So this is our expression. We have to use this expression only here. M is equal to 6q plus 1, and putting the value of this m into this expression. So 6q plus 1 whole square plus 23. Now simplifying a square 2ab plus b. This is a 24. After taking 12 common from this expression, this is like this. Now you can factorize the terms and you get this thing. Okay. Now this is, what is this? This is a product of two consecutive numbers. And you know that product of two consecutive numbers is always divisible by 2. So this is an even integer. Okay. So I can say that this is divisible by 2. This is divisible by 2. And this is also divisible by 2. It means this whole expression is divisible by 2. Now multiplying both sides by 12. So here it becomes 24 and this becomes this. And what is this? This is a by equation 1. This is the value of m square plus 23. So we have proved that 24 is divided by this one. So 24 divide this. Now we take another case. Another case, we have taken the value of 6q plus 5, again, whole square, opening the bracket, simplifying the result, taking 12 common and making the factorize, we get this thing. Now, what is this? Product of two consecutive integers. So, it is divisible by 2. This is divisible by 2. This is also divisible by 2 because here 2 occurs. So, this whole expression is divisible by 2. Okay? So here, this whole expression, this one, this expression is divisible by 2, multiplying both sides by 12, here 24 will divide this. And what is this? This is the value of m square plus 23. So we have proved here, 24 will divide this when m is not divisible by 2 and 3. Next example, very important question, examination point of view. We have to show that this is an integer. Integer means it is a simple a number, it is not a fraction. We have to show that it is an integer. So here we take n as a b and a as a 3. Okay, so n can be written as n is equal to 3q plus r. What are the different values of remainder here? 0, 1, 2. So we can write n like these things. Now take different cases. First of all, n is equal to 3q. Put value of n here. By putting the value of n 3q, and is simplifying these terms, 3 is cancelling with 3, So we get a simple number, so it is an integer. Second case, we taking the value n is equal to 3q plus 1, again put this value in the expression and simplifying the result, we get this expression from where we can take 3 common, so it will be cancelled out, again we get this is an integer. Okay, and third case is 3q plus 2, again put the value here, simplifying the result, expression, take 3 common from here, then this 3 will cancel with this 3, so we get an integer which is a free of fraction. So this is proved here, this is an integer. So in this video, students, we have discussed various examples which are solved using the Euclid's division algorithm. What is the division algorithm? If there are two integers a and b, then we can write b is equal to aq plus r, where q and r are quotient and remainder is always less than a. If you like my videos, please subscribe my channel, and thank you very much for watching my videos. Signing off, Dr. Gaurav Verma.